Je suis heureux d'être ici en compagnie de la Dr. Tam et du Dr. New. I want to start today with an update on COVID-19. In the last few days, Ontario and Quebec have had their highest ever numbers of cases. And across the country, totals have gone up, including in long-term care homes. That's not where any of us wanted to be on the way into Thanksgiving. But even if we can't gather this long weekend, we still have a chance to turn things around for Christmas. You're probably already wearing a mask when you go out. Now, more than ever, keep it up. The same goes for staying 2 meters apart and washing your hands. And if you haven't already, download the COVID Alert app now, which is another way of keeping yourself and others safe. 7 provinces have brought the app fully online, and we're expecting more news on this later today. COVID Alert is free and protects your privacy, so download it from Google Play or the App Store. The more people who sign up, the more powerful this tool will become. Already in Ontario, over 600 people have registered a positive result, which automatically notified thousands of people they came into contact with. Now is the time for all of us to use the app. Partout au pays, les cas de COVID-19 ont continué d'augmenter. Je vous demande, s'il vous plaît, de continuer à porter le masque, de garder vos distances et de vous laver les mains. On le répète souvent, je le sais, mais c'est parce que ces petits gestes peuvent faire une grande différence. Et si vous ne l'avez pas déjà fait, téléchargez gratuitement l'application Alerte COVID à partir de l'App Store ou de Google Play. 7 provinces y adhèrent maintenant et le gouvernement du Québec fera une annonce à ce sujet très bientôt. La priorité numéro 1 de notre gouvernement, c'est la sécurité des gens. Nous nous sommes maintenant procuré plus de 2 milliards d'articles de protection individuelle pour les Canadiens. Au cours du mois dernier, notre gouvernement a livré des dizaines de millions d'articles aux provinces et aux territoires, qu'il s'agisse d'écrans faciaux, de masques, de blouses ou de gants. Au sujet des instruments de dépistage comme les écouvillons, nous avons non seulement approvisionné les provinces et territoires, mais on a aussi maintenant 2 entreprises canadiennes qui sont autorisées à fournir des écouvillons fabriqués ici au pays avec des imprimantes 3D. Pour les vaccins, la semaine passée, Santé Canada a reçu sa première demande d'autorisation pour le candidat vaccin AstraZeneca auquel on s'est assuré d'avoir accès. C'est une autre étape franchie pour veiller à ce que les Canadiens obtiennent un vaccin sûr et efficace le plus tôt possible. Our government will continue doing everything we can to support people through this crisis, whatever it takes, as long as it takes. Yesterday, I had a very productive call with Mayor Tory of Toronto about addressing the challenges facing Canada's largest city. Later today, I'll be speaking with Mayor Watson from Ottawa and Mayor Brown from Brampton. Je vais aussi bientôt parler avec la mairesse Plante de Montréal et je viens juste de parler avec le maire Labaume de Québec. Beating this virus is a Team Canada effort, and we're here for Canadians right across the country. We've created the COVID Testing Assistance Response Team to quickly deploy across Canada because the federal government stands ready to help. Federal lab space is also providing surge support on processing of tests, including for Ontario for 1,000 tests a day. And additional federal labs will be added. On contact tracing, we have agreements in place with Ontario, Quebec, and Alberta, with more to come for other provinces and territories. There are 500 full-time contact tracers provided for Ontario, including 30 tracers specifically for Ottawa. At the same time, we're moving forward with programs that go directly to Canadians. As of this morning, applications for the Canada Recovery Sickness Benefit and the Canada Recovery Caregiving Benefit are open. These 2 programs are for Canadians not covered at work if they get COVID-19 or if their kids or parents get it and they have to take care of them. If you need this support, go to the CRA's My Account through Canada.ca or call 1-800-959-2019 or 1-800-595-2041. Sorry, 959-2041. Next week, Applications will also open for the Canada Recovery Benefit to support people who are directly affected by COVID-19 but can't access EI. These three new programs, the Recovery Benefit, the Sickness Benefit, and the Caregiving Benefit, are there for you. À compter de ce matin, les demandes pour la prestation canadienne de maladie pour la relance économique, ainsi que les demandes pour la prestation canadienne de la relance économique pour les prochains dents, sont maintenant acceptées. Si vous avez besoin de cette aide, rendez-vous sur l'outil en ligne en passant par le site canada.ca pour accéder à la section « Mon dossier » de l'Agence du revenu du Canada ou composez le 1-800-959-2019 ou 1-800-959-2041. La semaine prochaine, le processus s'ouvrira afin de recevoir les demandes pour la prestation canadienne de la relance économique. Ces trois prestations sont là pour vous. This fall is turning out to be pretty challenging for a lot of Canadians, including for young people. For students, I know this isn't the Thanksgiving, let alone the year, that you had hoped for. But even if things are different this long weekend, I hope you still take some time, probably online, with loved ones. If you're feeling overwhelmed or if you're struggling, reach out. You have a whole network, families, friends, teachers, that's there for you. I know we're going through really tough times right now. Everyone is. But we need you, your strength, your resilience, your vision for the future. We will continue to be there for you. And you got this. À ce propos, je voudrais souligner la Journée mondiale des enseignants. À tous nos enseignants et éducateurs d'un bout à l'autre du pays, je tiens à vous dire merci. C'est pas facile et la situation est loin d'être idéale. Mais malgré tout, vous continuez de faire un travail incroyable. Chaque jour, vous êtes dévoués et vous faites une énorme différence dans la vie des jeunes. Plus tard aujourd'hui, on va annoncer le nom des 71 éducateurs exceptionnels de partout au pays qui vont se voir remettre les prix du Premier ministre pour l'excellence dans l'enseignement. Ce sont des gens qui croient en nos enfants et, ce faisant, ils contribuent à bâtir un avenir plus prometteur pour nous tous. As a dad and as someone who spent time at the front of a classroom, I know just how important teaching can be. Of course, even in regular times, the job is not without its challenges. And right now, teachers are facing circumstances that none of us could ever have predicted. So to teachers and educators across the country, thank you for everything you do. Not only are you navigating health rules and online learning, you're guiding young people through an incredibly difficult and challenging new world. You're there for our kids and know that our government will be there for you. We created the $2 billion Safe Return to Class Fund to keep you and your students safe. For Edmonton Public Schools, this money has helped with rapid testing to protect staff and students. For schools in London, Ontario, it has meant buying more PPE and hiring additional teachers. And right across the country, this investment is going towards keeping all of our classrooms healthy. Comme on l'a fait par l'entremise du Fonds pour une rentrée scolaire sécuritaire, on va continuer de trouver d'autres moyens d'assurer la sécurité de tous les Canadiens. Aplatir la courbe, que ce soit dans les écoles ou les milieux de travail, c'est notre priorité absolue pour les prochaines semaines. And finally, I want to let Canadians know that I've asked the Foreign Minister to travel to Europe to discuss with our allies the developments in Eastern Europe and the Caucasus, particularly in Nagorno-Karabakh. Thank you very much.